So again, I am explaining lower Darboxum with the help of graph. So assume that the real valued bounded function f has an increasing function. That means f is increasing function. So the graph of f will be like this, increasing function like this. Right. So for this increasing function, lower Darboxum equal to sum of areas of the rectangles under the curve y is equal to f of x. So lower Darboxum is equal to sum of the areas of rectangles, sum of areas of the rectangles under this curve. So this rectangle, this rectangle, this rectangle, this like this. Here we have divided AB into n subintervals. The partition is t0, t1, t2, t3, so on, tn is equal to b. So lower Darboxum is equal to sum of areas of the rectangles under the curve y is equal to f of x. So length of the rectangle is infimum of f in the subinterval. Infimum of f in the subinterval. So this is the length. So this length of the rectangle is equal to infimum. And breadth is width of the subinterval, this one. Width of the subinterval. That means this is t1, this is t2. So this one is t1 minus t0, t2 minus t1, t3 minus t2, so on, tn minus tn minus 1. Now, so formula is sigma k is equal to 1 to n, m of f comma ik, infimum of f on the subinterval ik into tk minus tk minus 1. So this is the length of the rectangle, this is the width of the rectangle. Here ik is k the subinterval, close interval tk minus 1 to tk. So by writing k is equal to 1, we will get this one. K is equal to 2, we will get this one. K is equal to 3, we will get this one. And for writing k is equal to n, we will get this one. Since the function is an increasing function, so therefore f of ik, that means range of f is subset of closed interval f of tk minus 1 comma f of tk. So since f is increasing function, infimum is equal to f of tk minus 1. That means by substituting tk minus 1 in f, we will get infimum. And supremum is equal to f of tk. By substituting tk value in f, we will get supremum. So, next, this is important. If the function is decreasing, then these values will become reverse, right? Infimum is equal to f of tk and supremum is equal to f of tk minus 1. Infimum is equal to f of tk and supremum is equal to f of tk minus 1. Now, upper Darboxum, the graph of upper Darboxum of an increasing function, right? So the graph of increasing function is like this. Here also we have divided AB into n subintervals. This is t0, t1, t2, t3, tn minus 1, so on, tn. So upper Darboxum is equal to sum of the areas of the rectangles above the curve. So lower Darboxum equal to sum of areas of the rectangles. Sum of areas of the rectangles under the curve y is equal to f of x. So lower Darboxum is sum of areas of the rectangles under the curve. So e rectangles area. So upper Darboxum is sum of the areas of the rectangles above the curve, right? these rectangles, like this. Now this one is already I have explained this one. Sigma k is equal to 1, tk minus tk minus 1 equal to tn minus t0, that is equal to b minus k. So this is the theorem. It is very important theorem. We will use this one in next classes. Now, to start, the statement of the theorem is, let f be a bounded function on a b, small m comma capital M be the infimum and supremum of f on a b, then for any partition p of a b, then any partition p of a b, we have this inequality, m of f comma close interval a comma b into b minus a less than or equal to lower Darboux sum l of f comma p less than or equal to u of f comma p upper Darboux sum. That means the lower Darboux sum of a function is less than upper Darboux sum of a function for any partition. Lower Darboux sum is less than or equal to upper Darboux sum, right? Because in L we have we will take infimums, in this one supremums. Infimum is always less than supremum, so therefore lower Darboux sum is less than or equal to upper Darboux sum. So this result is very important. We will use in next classes. So m of f comma close interval a comma b into b minus a e less than or equal to l of f comma p lower Darboux sum and u f comma p upper Darboux sum less than or equal to m of f comma ab, that means supremum of f in the close interval ab into b minus a. So this is true for any partition. So this inequality is true for any partition. Let p is equal to t0, t1, t2, tk minus 1, tk, so on, tn is equal to any partition of ab. That means here we have divided the interval ab into n subintervals. Since f is bounded on ab, it is a bounded function. Therefore, f is also bounded on each of the subintervals, close interval tk minus 1, comma tk for k is equal to 1, 2, 3, n. So, f ఇక్కడ a by ab పైన బౌండెడ్ అయింది కాబట్టి ab ఈ మధ్యలో ఉన్న అన్ని సబ్ ఇంటర్వెల్స్ పైన f బౌండెడ్ అవుతుంది. సో f ఇస్ బౌండెడ్ ఆన్ a కామా b. సో ఈ మొత్తం ఇక్కడ వరకు బౌండెడ్ కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ ఉన్న ప్రతి సబ్ ఇంటర్వెల్ లో f బౌండెడ్ అవుతుంది. సో వి నో దట్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫస్ట్ చాప్టర్ ఫర్ s సబ్సెట్ ఆఫ్ t ఇన్ఫిమ ఆఫ్ s ఇస్ గ్రేటర్ దన్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఇన్ఫిమ ఆఫ్ t అండ్ సుప్రీమ ఆఫ్ s ఇస్ లెస్ దన్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ టు సుప్రీమ ఆఫ్ t. Now, close interval tk minus 1, comma tk is subset of a comma b. ఎందుకంటే ఇది దీని యొక్క సబ్ ఇంటర్వెల్ కాబట్టి సబ్సెట్ ఆఫ్ ab. So therefore, by applying this one, infimum of this one is greater than or equal to infimum of this one. So infimum of f comma close interval tk minus 1, comma tk is greater than or equal to infimum of f comma close interval a comma b. And similarly, supremum of this one is less than or equal to supremum of f comma ab. So by this, so infimum of f of a comma b is less than or equal to supremum of f comma ab. అంటే మన ఫర్ ఎనీ ఫంక్షన్ ఎఫ్ ఇన్ ఎనీ ఇంటర్వెల్ ఇన్ఫ్యూమ్ ఈజ్ ఆల్వేస్ లెస్ దెన్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ టు సుప్రీమం. సో నౌ వీ విల్ కంబైన్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఇన్ఈక్వాలిటీస్ 1, 2, 3. సో కంబైనింగ్ ఆల్ దీస్ ఇన్ఈక్వాలిటీస్ వీ గెట్ దట్ ఫస్ట్ వన్. ఐఎమ్ రైటింగ్ దిస్ వన్ ఇన్ఫ్యూమ్ ఆఫ్ ఎఫ్ ఓవర్ ద ఇంటర్వెల్ close interval a comma b is less than or equal to infimum of f over tk minus 1 comma tk, this one. Again, so infimum is less than or equal to supremum of f over close interval tk minus 1 comma tk, because any infimum is less than supremum. Again, by this one, supremum of f over close interval tk minus 1 over tk is less than or equal to supremum of f over close interval a comma b. So by using this, if a subset of t, infimum of s is greater than or equal to infimum of t, supremum of s is less than or equal to supremum of t. So closed interval tk minus 1 comma tk is subset of a comma b. So therefore, infimum of this one is greater than or equal to infimum of this one, and supremum of this one is less than or equal to supremum of this one. And for any partition, for any function, for any closed interval, infimum of a function is always less than or equal to supremum of that function in the given interval. So now we are combining 1, 2, 3. First, I am writing infimum of f over closed interval a comma b. That means first I am writing this one. First I am writing this one. So infimum over tk minus 1, tk minus 1 comma tk always less than or equal to supremum. And by 2, supremum of f comma closed interval tk minus 1 comma tk is less than or equal to supremum of f over closed interval a comma b. So multiplying the inequality by tk minus tk minus 1. I am multiplying the previous inequality by tk minus 1. By tk minus 1, tk minus tk minus 1, we get that infimum of f over closed interval a comma b into tk minus 1, because tk minus 1 is positive. Kabatti inequality ni multiply cheyadam valla inequality maru as it is untundi, and this one. So again, taking the summation for k is equal to 1 2 3 so on to the above inequality, by taking sigma k is equal to 1 to n, this one, sigma k is equal to 1 to n for this one, this term and this term. So first we are multiplying with tk minus 1, and we are taking summation for k is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on n to the above inequality. That means we are adding these n inequalities. We are adding these n inequalities. For k is equal to 1, we will get 1 inequality. K is equal to 2, k is equal to 3, k is equal to 4, and k is equal to so on. So we are adding all n inequalities. So in other way, taking the summation for k is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on n to the above inequality. So just I am writing this symbol, summation to every term. Right. So infimum of f a comma b is small m. I am writing this as it is. So this is lower Darboux sum, definition of lower Darboux sum. This is definition of upper Darboux sum. And supremum of f a comma b is capital M into width of the interval tk minus 1. Now I am taking M outside because the summation is over k, right?